Hey y'all, it's Kristen. We are going to make some ephemera and things for this baby book I'm working on. I made this. I thought it was really cute. I used the stickers. Hang on just a second. I used these stickers that I get at Hobby Lobby. And this is really cute because, I mean, it feels like fabric. And then there's a little bow right there. But anyway, we're going to make one of these, even though I've already made one. We may make one for the girl journal too. I've been using these stamps that Laura gave me. Hi, Laura. Thank you. And let's see. What else are we going to do? Oh, I think I'm going to make a shaker tag using this stamp right here. And I've also got this. I love this stamp. And I usually use, I think these are 4x6. Hang on. Let's just see. Yep. Yeah, so I use 4x6 index cards, just turn it over, that way the lines are on the other side if you want to write on it. I stamp it, and then I take one of my vintage stamps and put on it. But I think what I want to do is try to do the embossing with black, and then maybe even, like, go ahead and put the stamp and everything on it, and maybe make a shaker. I'm not sure. We're going to see. We're going to see how much time it takes to do all this. I've also got these stamps that I thought would be good in baby books. Okay, so let's just start on this tag. Let me move this over. Let's make this one first. Okay, first of all, I need to cut it out. I use this to... I've got a die that I can actually cut out tags, but I hate using the Big Shot. I know that sounds terrible, but it's such a pain in my butt, so we're just going to do it this way. How about it? And I just jacked it up. I'm cutting into the tag on top. Dang it. That'll work. Okay, let's see if it's gonna work again. This is Recollections embossing powder in the color Snow. I've got a little tray deal that is for embossing powder, like to do that, and then pour it back in your little container. But to me, just using a piece of paper is good enough. All right, where is my this? Let's wipe this off. I always miss some of it, but... And I kind of got that crooked, but it's all right. It's fine. I brought my camera down a little bit, so hopefully you can see better. The only thing is the arm is like right almost eye level with me. So I'm kind of having to not really look around it, but it's kind of like at my forehead. Okay, let's see. Now, anybody with headphones on? This is not like real loud, but I'm just saying, warning. Here we go. I'm going to hold this up so you guys can see it. All just love that. Okay. I'm going to have to put something on top of that and make it lay down. Let's see. Okay, that's good enough for right now. Where are my stickers? I think I'll just do the exact same one because it's just so cute. And I don't just stick stickers down, I glue them. Because you don't want stuff falling out of your book and that would be not good. I mean, you can just stick them down, but I do not. Let's see, what's on this one? Oh, you know what? I meant last time when I did this, I put all the stuff on. I was like, oh, I want to sew around it. So I did, but it was kind of hard. And I said this time I was going to sew around it first. And look at me, I forgot. So let's see. Maybe I'll do this. Oops. And ooh, don't stick down. Yeah. Let me think about this a second. I know I want to do this one, so let's put this down. Do I want to put it? Let's see how it works out. And then sometimes what I'll do is literally cut these out to where I can set them. On top without the sticky part bugging me. All right. So I had this, but these are kind of both round, and so, I don't know, I'm weird about things. What was Lehman telling me the other day? Hi, Lehman. She was saying, I just love watching you because you're so precise. I think that's what she said. I was like, yeah, I've got a little bit of OCD about things. All right, let's see. Or we could just do two of these. I think I want to do that. Like reposition them, but yep, I'm gonna do these little whatever they are, safety pins that are really cute. Makes me a little bit nervous just putting glue where the sticky part is, and I may go back and like sew over it or something. And this may not work with two. Hang on a second, let me see. I might have accidentally put that in the wrong place. Yeah, I'm gonna have to glue a little bit more on those. Sometimes you can get away with doing that. Come on, I have tried to get this piece of plastic off me a whole lot of times and it's just staying. So let's put a little here and a little down here. And we'll take that other one off real fast in just a second. And I'm going to stick a little bit of glue behind here. I mean, tiny amount, and it's still squished out, but that's okay. It'll dry. I almost glued my finger down. I wasn't paying attention. Yeah, that's going to show a little bit. It'll be a little bit shiny, but that's fine. It's okay. No big deal. And this one, is it stuck down yet? Nope. I'm going to glue a little bit more. That's good. That's fine. Okay. There we go. So I'll just sew around that later, and it'll be ready for another baby book. But this one, I'm actually going to put in the book right now. I thought my scissors were broken. All right. Let's see here. I had a place that I wanted to put it. These are little pieces from the scrapbooking paper. One minute, just let me look right quick, because I'm almost positive that I had an actual place that I wanted to put this, and now I don't remember. And that's how I use the ViewMasters, just for those of you who are new. I make a little tuck spot out of it. I have those available in the shop. Maybe not. I could put it there. And it would be a good spot because there's two pages in that. But does it really go? Because that's kind of... Yeah, because that... It does. Right? This is the times I wish that I was alive so y'all could be like, yeah, it's great. Yeah. I think I'll put it there. And you see how it sticks out a little bit? So I'm going to poke a hole, I think. Maybe. Do I even have enough room with the arm there? What I was going to do is poke a hole and then put some of this stuff through it and have that sticking out. But I'm almost a little bit scared. Let's see how big the hole is going to be. I'll turn it this way so I can see what's happening. that was scary. That was suspenseful. I just knew I was fixing to jack this up. Now let's see if it's going to look good outside the book. This may just be a tag that we put in the book. I don't think I like this stuff for what I'm trying to do here, is what I'm saying. Let's see. Let's cut it down a little bit. That's fine. You see what I'm trying to figure out here? I want to make sure it's going to look halfway decent. And I'm going to pull it up a little bit from the bottom. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. And it's not bothering the, like, not bulking up the actual pages because it's on the outside. Or at least I hope that's what's going to happen. Okay. This is why it takes me forever. Because I'm back and forth and thinking about it too much. That glue's fixing to get all over the other pages. Now, that is going to have to dry for a minute. Okay. Let me let this dry. I need to go get a drink of water or something, and I will be right back. Okay, so this has dried. It is several hours later. I've cooked supper and eaten and all that stuff, so I don't have to worry about that. So there you go. It's just made it into a pocket. And it will close fine. It's good. Yeah. Okay. So we are going to, what are we going to do? I want to I'm thinking. Just a minute. Actually, you know what? I need to make another tag and I do want to use these hands. And I'm going to use that one. Okay. let's wipe this off. All right, one more time with the heat tool, people. Trying to decide. I think what I want to do is do I want to do a shaker? Is that what I said at the beginning of this video? I don't know. It's been a few hours. I'm also thinking, hang on. I have these stickers that go with the paper pad or paper pack that I used. I want to look at these just a second because I kind of want to put something right there. Am I in frame? Okay. So can y'all see all of these? Am I even recording? I'm telling you, maybe I need to go have some coffee. Anybody else get kind of tired when you after you eat? I mean, I get really tired sometimes. Sometimes it's like taking a tranquilizer or something. Let's see here. I really like that right there. It's too big, but I still like him. We could put a word or words like that's kind of cute, huh? Yeah, that's pretty cute. I was thinking about putting fabric behind it, but I really don't think I will. I mean, it's got the scallop around it, plus I'm going to make it a shaker, so. Okay. That's what we're going to do. I wish this would lay flat. Even. All right. Now, that looks pretty straight. Now, what we're going to do is I have to get some sequins. Just a second. All right. So I have these. Can you see in there? They're little. That. So I could do that, or I could do these. And I know I have some more, but whoops. I think I want to do the blue, although I really like the white. I think I'll just do the blue. Yeah. Okay. So, let's get a piece of this. I'm gonna cut it right there. Let me make sure this is not gonna move. Okay, I'm gonna go sew this on three sides and I will be right back. Okay, so I jacked this one up a little bit. So aggravating. I mean, it's not the end of the world, and I'll still use it, but maybe once I get the sequins in there, nobody will be able to tell. My acetate moved while I was trying to sew. So, there you go. Let me move this, and we'll put some sequins in and hope that they don't catch on anything. And get them everywhere. I might put a few more. I don't really like to put a whole lot. So, and it's a little bit tight because, like I said, I did it wrong, but it's still fine. I'm gonna go sew the top. I'll be right back. Okay, there you go. I'm gonna cut some of these strings off a little bit. Yeah, that's fine. I mean, even though I messed up down there, see, it's still cute and it still keeps the sequins in. So we're gonna punch a hole if I can find this. I was like, where did that come from? It came out of a hole punch. And all right. Ooh, I almost cut the other one. Did you see that? Oh. All right. That's good. And we'll just stick it. In the book. In the pocket. We'll just pick one. I wonder if it'll fit in there or if I need something smaller. I bet I do. I bet my glue ran. Let's see. No? It fits. I don't really know if I want it right there. Let's look. Where's one of the big ones? There. That'll work. Okay. So now I'm going to go have some coffee and I'll be right back. Okay. I want to try something. I've had some coffee. Feel a little better. I want to stamp these, but I want to do a background on these. Let me get my paper again that I had a second ago. And also, Mrs. Coggs was talking about these. I bought these last year, before Christmas, for my daughter. And she never used them. And I was like, when I saw her video, I was like, ooh, I have some of those. So, we are going to try these out for stenciling. Now, which one do I want to do? Because I don't remember. Let's try this one. These are foundation brushes. Okay. And I want to do Do I want to do stars? Also, what color? Just a minute. Okay, let's try. You can hardly see the name. Let's try Broken China and Peeled Paint. I'm going to do an ombre effect. Hopefully, we'll see. Whoops. These work pretty good. Thank you, Mrs. Cox. I forget her name. Liz? I'm not sure. I'm sorry. Okay. We're going to do that. And kind of wipe that off. This one. I literally go over kind of the ones that I already did, you know, just a little bit, like right there, and that's it. Okay, let's see what happened. That's kind of cute. Let me put the lid on this. Let's move this over. Actually, all of this over. Wipe this off. I know I said I was going to do a postcard thing, but I changed my mind, mainly because postcards don't really go with the baby books. At least I don't think so. I'm not sure. I might decide to do one later, just not right now. Now, what I really want to know is, where's the elephant? I don't know if this will stamp over that or not. I probably should have done it a little lighter. Me. Or. What about putting on one of these stickers? I think that one is too big, yes. So, we'll figure out something else. What about this little giraffe right here? Am I even in frame? I know I ask that every video, I swear, that comes out of my mouth every time. Will this work? Yeah, but I kind of feel like he needs something behind him. Okay, let's not do that one. I really want to know if these stamps, I don't think these stamps are good enough to stamp over this and look good. I guess we could always just try it and see what it looks like. Now, I think I'm going to use this, not the Memento. Let's just try it out. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. We'll start over. Nope. I knew that was going to happen. Okay. It's fine. No big deal. This stamp needs to be stamped like to a page, like in the corner, because it's so thin. Where's a wipe? What'd I do with it? But you know what? It's okay because I can stick something over him and still use that tag. I don't have to throw it away. Alright, so, whoops. I don't know. Let me look at. I have too much stuff up here. It's making my brain hurt. Scooch over, put that up. I took these out the other day and went ahead and edged, like, distressed around them with distress oxide in the blue color. So I wouldn't have to do that. That's kind of cute. So is that. I kind of like the giraffe. And I think what I'm going to do is go sew. Let me stick him down with some glue stick. Hang on. Okay. Just a little, just to keep him. Okay, let me go sew around him and I'll be right back. Okay. I think it's pretty cute. I'm kind of done with the tags right now. I think what we're going to do is put the book corners on the book. And I'll put some kind of ribbon in there later. We're going to put the book corners on the book and I don't know. Let me get that situated. Just a minute. Okay. Let's see what these are going to look like, first of all. I bought these. I'm going to show you. hoping, I got these on Amazon. I'll link them down in the description box. But I got these hoping these would look good on the, yeah, they will. I think they look just fine. I need my, something to clamp these down. Hang on just a minute, I'll be right back. Okay, I got one on right there. We're gonna put the other on. I use glossy accents for anything I don't want to go anywhere, like stuff for the cover. Like if I'm gonna, you know, glue something down on the cover or whatever, and I don't want it to ever move again, this is what I use. So we are gonna use some of this stuff in here. Probably gonna squeeze that a little bit. Okay. Now, that's good. Now I just have to do the back ones. And then I think that I will be done, except for I'm going to go through here and put some of those ephemera pieces and stickers in some of the places. I may also try to use those stamps, but I wish I would have thought of that before I sewed the signatures in, which, by the way, I did not show sewing the signatures in, first of all, because it's a pain in the butt, and secondly, I was going to do the Nick the Booksmith hidden spine. And I was stupid and put this lace down. Can you see that? I did that first and then realized, oh wait, I can't do that if I'm gonna. I needed to do the, put the signatures in first, then put the lace down. And I did it backwards. So I ended up just sewing the signatures into the spine. All right. What do I want to do? I'm gonna put something here. Ooh, my hands have this glue on them. Okay, let me. I'll put the back book corners on off camera because that's kind of nitpicky. Okay, let's see here. Keep hitting my head. Okay. Here's what we're fixing to do. We're going to take a little bit of this glue. We're going to draw a line. Normally, I would sew this in, but this is a last minute decoration, so we're going to stick it down. Keep losing my whites. Imagine I'm gonna find a bunch on the floor over there on the other side of my table. Okay. Then we're going to take this there. Now, I think, do I want to put something on the other side? Just kind of make that a continuous thing. I don't know, that might be cute. Let's see. And then put what? Why are you not sticking down? Or I guess I could do that. Sweet baby boy, you are loved. It's kind of a continuation. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. Okay, here we go. Everywhere. Something's going to be stuck to itself. I'm going to say, how did that happen? Okay. Okay. All right, I'm going to stop this video right here. And the next time you see me, I will probably be doing a flip through of this journal. And we're going to be working on traveler's notebooks. Okay? I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already. And thank you so much for watching.